People ask me all the time, what is UDL? UDL is Universal Design for Learning, and it is not a new name for differentiated instruction. There is a framework, Universal Design for Learning, and there is a framework, differentiated instruction. And although they can be used to complement each other, they are absolutely not the same thing. So let's talk about a little analogy that I like to use to explain the difference. Imagine for a moment that I was going to have a smashing dinner party. Now, if it was universally designed, I want to make sure that everybody is going to have an awesome meal at my party. And so I'm going to anticipate or predict the variability of possible guests. Now, as my best friends, you're all invited. And you're going to bring partners and friends, and I might not know exactly what they eat. But worry not. I can predict the variability. I'm gonna predict that some people might be lactose intolerant, might be vegan or vegetarian, have cultural needs, or they might be picky eaters. And when I can predict this, I realize that it would be a really bad idea to serve a casserole, right? Because imagine you come into my party, you're thinking you're gonna have an awesome time, boom, tuna noodle. Oh, I'm gonna exclude a lot of people. But here's the thing, when I think universally, I recognize the importance of having different options and choices for everyone. And so when I universally design a party, I am going to serve a buffet. And the same thing happens in my classroom, is we can recognize and embrace the incredible variability of our students and identify the barriers that we know that some students face. And so if I recognize that I might have some students who struggle with language, some students who are decoding below grade level, some students who need additional challenges, I can create a buffet of ways for students to learn and share what they know using firm goals and flexible means. Now, differentiated instruction uses flexible groupings to make decisions about what specific students need. It's a great way to provide tier 2 support or additional intervention for your students, but when you plan using differentiated instruction, it can feel a little bit like you are a short order cook. If you're coming to my party and I say, I'm gonna have to make something for the people who are lactose intolerant, and I have to have another dish for everyone who is vegan, and I wanna make sure I have something gluten-free, I am now a short order cook and my kitchen is on fire. And here's the thing, you don't get to make choices for yourself. So we want to universally design instruction, we want to be really proactive and planful about identifying barriers and making sure that we're not reacting and providing additional dishes for every student. So the next time you feel a little frazzled and on fire with planning because you're worried about every single group of students, take a step back, identify some barriers, and make a flexible buffet and allow learners to self-differentiate and self-direct their learning. Because at a buffet, when everyone makes their own plate and you provide feedback and support those choices, I'm telling you, it is a much better party.